Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. The hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for such the Father seeks to worship him. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, in the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all of your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Come, let us adore him.
We will now say the Venite in unison.
Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it. And his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. We will now say Psalm 124. We will say it by full verse. If the Lord has not been made on our side, let Israel now say, If the Lord has not been made on our side when enemies rose up against us, then would they have swallowed us up alive in their fierce anger towards us? Then would the waters have overwhelmed us and the torrent gone over us. Then would the raging waters have gone right over us? Blessed be the Lord. He has not given us over to be prey for their teeth. We have accepted like a bird from the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken, and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of the heaven and earth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
The Holy Gospel of our Savior according to Matthew. When Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, but others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And Peter answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." Then he sternly ordered the disciples not to tell anyone that he was the Messiah. The Gospel of our Savior. It's a major election year, and for better or worse, the pollsters already are hard at work. We read the results to learn whom people trust and for whom they will vote. An election and its preceding polls reveal as much about the voters and their hopes, concerns, and fears as they do the candidates, their image, their popularity, and campaign efforts. Jesus and his disciples are in the mountains north of Galilee at Caesarea Philippi, named for Caesar Augustus and governed for the Romans by Herod's son Philip. The city was a regional base for the Roman militia and government. Temples dedicated to the Greek god Pan and to others displayed the region's religious diversity. A trade route nearby made the local economy prosper. And in the midst of this intersection of politics, power, religion, and trade, Jesus asked about the polls. Who do people say that I am? The disciples provide a number of responses. And then Jesus asked pointedly, who do you say that I am? You, as in you all together, as a group. What Jesus seeks is not a right answer, a response of the intellect, or scholarly research. Jesus wants to know about their heart, their trust, their commitment, their allegiance. The response will tell as much about them as about Jesus. Peter proclaims, "You are the Christ," the Greek word for Messiah, God's chosen anointed one, the Son of the living God, to which Jesus then offers his blessing, "And you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church." Now, altogether in the four Gospels, the word church occurs only two times, and this is one of them. Here, church is connected to Peter's confession of Jesus as Christ. Jesus will build his church on Peter in his confession of faith as Christ. Fittingly, we come together as Christ's church. Who do we together say Jesus is? How do we, through our life together, confess Jesus as Christ? Now, I've been thinking a lot recently about Dietrich Bonhoeffer, the situation in which he lived, and our own. Bonhoeffer was a German Lutheran pastor and an active Nazi resister. When Hitler took over the German church, Bonhoeffer helped form the Independent Confessing Church. Bonhoeffer was executed 75 years ago, April 9th, for his participation in a plot to kill Hitler. His heart was set on Christ, on faithful discipleship, on a church solely committed to Christ. In his doctoral dissertation, Bonhoeffer declared that Christ exists and lives today as the community of the church. And the community of the church, Christ and God's love are made real. And the community of the church, God's unbounded love in Christ and the Holy Spirit conquer human selfishness and sin, create lives of sacrifice and service, mutual forgiveness, prayer, and intercession. Now, at the time, Peter did not fully appreciate what his confession of Christ meant. We today may not fully appreciate ours either. Neither is saying the words or any words ever the same as living them out. Peter would be crucified himself, tradition says, upside down. Inspired by Christ's Sermon on the Mount and Gandhi's nonviolent pacifism, Bonhoeffer could not have ever imagined participating in a plot to kill Hitler. Loving and trusting Christ, following his way of love, can take us, as Peter and Bonhoeffer would discover, to places we'd rather not go. And we may fail at living out Christ's unconditional love in our words and acts, values, and priorities. But listen, Jesus nevertheless promised, "You are Peter, on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it." Peter, you and I, we are not perfect rocks, solid, strong, a towering mountain. But Jesus is the bedrock underneath us, the tectonic plates deep beneath the earth that hold up continents and lift mighty mountains high above the seas. Jesus, God's Son, costumed in human flesh and blood, is like Charlie Brown, trick-treating on Halloween, who announces, "I got a rock." But Jesus doesn't throw it away. Jesus loves and takes us rocks home, washes us clean in our baptism, paints and anoints us with oil, and then makes us God's own. A teenage boy was battling cancer. Radiation treatments had taken his hair. The doctors had to amputate his arm. He lay in the hospital, drifting in and out of consciousness. Throughout his ordeal, his parents sat at his side. During a lucid moment, he opened his eyes and said, "I'm scared. I don't even know who I am." His father asked him gently, "Do you know who I am?" "Yes," the boy replied, "you are my dad." And then said the boy's father, "Don't worry, son, because I know who you are." In all of the manifold challenges we face, especially today, our words and deeds and votes may contradict what we believe deep inside about Jesus and God's will for creation and all people. We may lose sight of what we truly stand for, what and whom we truly believe. We may not know who we are. We may become a riddle even to ourselves. Are we what others think of us, or what we think of ourselves? Are we the good persons and heroes others tell us we are and should be, or are we the weak, failed, fearful person we inside think we are? Dietrich Bonhoeffer asked those same questions in a poem a month before his execution. Who am I, this or the other? Am I one person today and tomorrow another? Whoever I am, thou knowest, O God, I am thine. God knows who you are. You are God's. You are God's own beloved sons and daughters. You are Christ's brothers and sisters, for whom Christ died, for whom and in whom Christ lives. You are a rock found and saved, washed, painted, precious, and deeply loved. Jesus will not leave or disown you. Upon you and your confession of Christ, the forgiveness you share and the love you give, Christ will build his church. On you, Christ will build up this congregation. And remember the promise. The gates of hell and evil, the gates of hate and injustice and sin and death, those gates will not prevail against you. Amen.
Let us say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Save your people, Lord, and bless their inheritance. Govern and uphold them now and always. Day by day, we bless you. We praise your name forever. Lord, keep us from all sin today. Have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we put our trust in you. And you, Lord, is our hope, and we shall never hope in vain. Grant, O merciful God, that your church, being gathered together in unity by your Holy Spirit, may show forth your power among all peoples to the glory of your name. To Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Lord God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray. Let us pray for the church, for Michael, our presiding bishop, Dee Dee, our bishop, Rick, our interim rector, St. Paul's Church in Endicott, and their rector, the Reverend John Marchino, St. Andrew's Church in Evans Mills, and their rector, the vicar, Reverend Ann Wichelins. For our search process, dear God, giver of every good gift, look graciously on your whole church and our parish. Help us, we pray, as we search both for a new rector and for your proper direction in our life together. Open our minds to your guidance through prayer, peacefulness, and through listening attentively to the people of this parish in love. Prepare us to receive a faithful pastor who will care for all your people and equip us to serve you in your parish, in our families, in the community, and beyond. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We pray for those who are in college and graduate school. Alex, Emily, Austin, Amelia, Baden, Brad, Sarah, Matthew, Sarah, Daniel, Audrey, Burke, Matt, Jack, and Stephen. We pray for those who are in need of God's healing presence. Sandy, Sue, Judy, Frank, Linda,
Matt, Marcia, Emily, Loretta, Jackie, Jerry, David, Allison, and Rosaire. We give thanks for those celebrating a birthday this week: Christine Zappia, Richard Baggett, Stephen Elliott, and Jean Regan. For those celebrating an anniversary this week: Suzanne and John Ball, and Kim and Bill Jeffrey.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise not only with our lips but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all of our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. God of all power and love, we give thanks for your unfailing presence and the hope you provide in times of uncertainty and loss. Send your Holy Spirit to enkindle in us your holy fire. Revive us to live as Christ's body in the world, a people who pray, worship, learn, break bread, share life, heal neighbors, bear good news, seek justice, rest, and grow in the Spirit. Wherever and however we gather, unite us in common prayer and send us in common mission, that we and the whole creation might be restored and renewed. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Now may God give you grace never to sell yourself short, grace to risk something big for something good, and grace to remember that the world is too dangerous for anything but truth and too small for anything but love. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.